My name is Shubhra Sinha Kamath, and I'm a senior product manager within Azure Security. Today, we'll talk about decentralized role-based access control for your existing applications. I'll walk you through the Azure Confidential Computing background. Then we'll spend a little bit on confidential cloud concepts. Then we'll discuss how confidential computing powers data sharing and analytics app development with CCF. And then we'll go through managed CCF. So today, as you know, there's existing cloud services encrypt data at rest when the data is stored in the storage or database, and in transit when it's flowing between public and private networks. With confidential computing, we take it a step further. It protects your data during computation as well. The computation happens in an isolated environment in the chip called enclaves or trusted execution environments. So within Azure, there are really two aspects here to consider. Confidential computing here means a hardware root of trust with customer verifiable remote attestation and memory protection. This minimizes the attack surface and allows end-to-end encryption, which makes it hard for hackers and malicious users to get access to your important data. Let's go through some of the key concepts of confidential computing that we will be talking about today. Beginning with the top left, the trusted execution environment is a secure area of a main processor. It guarantees code and data loaded inside the protected with respect to confidentiality and integrity, and these are often called TEEs or enclaves. Next is the bottom left. Remote attestation allows the ability to verify the integrity of the environment before making any transactions. A remote client can pull an attestation report from the hardware and can be certain that a server is running the intended code isolated in a TEE. These components allow the cloud provider to be outside the trusted computing base, as shown in the top right. Another aspect in keeping all of this is the history. For instance, transactions happened in the enclaves themselves are logged in an immutable ledger and makes it immutable and auditable. So next, we will discuss the background around confidential computing consortium framework and its related technologies. We will first talk about the problems our customers bring up. Many companies are dealing with sensitive data such that data is often requiring confidentiality, and they make sure that only authorized people have access to the data. They want to keep the trust as minimal as possible and even excluding the cloud provider. These companies want to share data with multiple parties for specific purposes, yet retain control over the data. What they're looking for here is customizable governance. With sensitive data that is being shared in a confidential way comes the concern for maintaining transparency and auditability. In fact, it is no longer sufficient to make a legal promise not to do something. This means that there is a need for overall confidentiality, as there is no one-size-fits-all solution, and each case is unique. There is a need for flexibility and customizability. Often, all of this is required with base needs of scaling in a sustainable way, with the least amount of operational pains, and ensuring that dev teams can ramp up quickly on new systems using familiar tools and libraries. The Cambridge UK team at Microsoft Research built the Confidential Consortium Framework, or CCF, to solve the problems customers were surfacing. The open source framework is ideal for building secure, highly available, and performant applications. It combines enclaves with flexible, decentralized governance to solve remote multi-party challenges. CCF executes centrally with decentralized trust. That means that CCF is more efficient and sustainable when compared to other traditional solutions. A simplified view of the CCF network displays that there's an operator who maintains that nodes who are out of the trust boundary, a consortium of members who are in charge of governing the network, referred to as members or consortium, and users making business transactions to the network. Basic CCF network is made of three nodes, and all nodes run the same application inside the trusted execution environment. CCF is based on web technologies, and clients interact with CCF JavaScript applications over HTTPS. In this diagram, you see a notion of the consortium members who create the governance transactions, and the second portion is the users who utilize the business transactions. Today, we have an Azure managed service that provides customers the ability to use this framework to build their own CCF-aware multi-party applications with the power of Azure confidential computing. Developers can continue to build and host their CCF-aware applications in JavaScript and TypeScript on the framework, create consortiums with multi-parties to vote on proposals, and be able to utilize programmable confidentiality, while the service will manage code upgrades and disaster recovery. Here, you see a quick diagram of how the stateful applications would on top of Azure managed CCF. Finally, we wanted to show you a depiction of how CCF, the open source framework, differs from managed CCF, that is the managed version of CCF. Essentially, as you see on the right, customers or users would bring in their own applications and would be able to run it on the managed service.
Hello, my name is Yagnesh. I'm an engineering manager with the managed CCF and Azure Confidential Compute team. I'm going to switch gears and show managed CCF in action by introducing an enterprise supply chain application that requires participation from multiple stakeholders. Although this demo explores an application that requires participation from external stakeholders, the concept applies equally to intranet business applications that cater to internal needs. A common example is an application that is used to process employee reimbursement requests. It would require the participation of members from different departments like finance, business group administrators, and business group approvers. From our numerous customer interactions, we observed that such applications have complex workflows implemented over a period of time and contains business logic that relies on other areas of the business and is hard to migrate. Moreover, the applications are compartmentalized through a variety of mechanisms like access control lists and just-in-time authorization policies to protect sensitive data and intellectual property. The diagram shows the high-level design of a line of business application that has a user interface layer, a middleware layer, and a persistence layer. The user interface layer would be supported on both browsers and mobile applications. The middleware layer would be implemented as a set of microservices that uses service mesh for inter-service communication and asynchronous message processing. Besides that, there could be a few other hot, warm, and cold path data egress routes to enable analytics pipelines, monitoring and alerting services, and anomaly detections using log parsing. Customers provided feedback that they would like to enable confidentiality and decentralized access control for better auditability and to prevent unilateral changes. Also, a couple of core asks from the management was to enable auditability and transparency for the customers. While it is the right thing to do, the application owners faced challenges with committing to a multi-year Big Bang migration approach. It's quite understandable that it will not garner support from the upper management and is also a risky endeavor to overtake. Rather, they preferred a gradual step-by-step migration with minimal impact to the business operations. A core piece of functionality in any application is authentication and authorization. In majority of the cases, it is isolated from the business logic as it is provided by an on-premises or a cloud-based identity provider like Microsoft Entra ID. In the demo that follows, I will show how a supply chain application involving multiple parties could be lifted and shifted and integrated with a managed CCF application by decentralizing the authorization policies. The supply chain application used in this demo is used to manage the lifecycle of coffee beans from the farm to the hands of consumers. It has four personas, namely the farmer, distributor, retailer, and consumer. Each persona is assigned one or more roles that determines the set of actions that they can perform. Typically, enterprise applications use integrated authentication and authorization provided by an identity provider like Microsoft Entra ID. Upon login, the identity provider issues JWT tokens. The JWT token contains user information and claims that determines the actions they can perform. In this demo, we will show how the centralized authorization management can be decentralized by delegating it to a managed CCF application, which immediately enables immutability, auditability, and traceability. In the managed CCF application, the different members that are part of the application will become part of the consortium, which will set up the roles, actions, and the application users. Managed CCF can work with any identity provider that supports the OpenID Connect protocol. As you could see from the diagram, the top portion shows the role and action management being performed via governance, and the bottom portion shows the process for user management. The benefits with this governance-based approach is that it enables auditability and transparency and prevents unilateral changes to the application. Due to the immutability guaranteed by the underlying ledger, it is easy to audit the chronology of the changes. Although this demo talks about a supply chain application involving external stakeholders, the concepts will equally apply to an application that involves multiple internal stakeholders. Before starting the demo, I want to briefly reiterate the four personas and the actions they can perform. A farmer can harvest the coffee beans and advertise it for sale. A distributor can purchase it from the farmer and distribute it to the warehouse owned by the retailers. A retailer can process the coffee beans and put it up for sale on their website. A consumer can consume it by purchasing it from the retailer's website. With that, let's see a demo of the application. This demo uses the decentralized role-based access control application to maintain the authorization policies. The process to deploy a managed CCF resource and the decentralized RBAC application is described in the publicly available documentation. What we see on the screen is the account creation process for a farmer persona. Generally, in an enterprise application, users are managed in an on-premises or cloud-based identity provider, and single sign-on is enabled for authentication. In the demo, though, we show the account registration process to demonstrate the existence of different personas. As you could see, there are four different personas I explained earlier. We can now log in using the farmer credentials. When the user logged in, the web application called the middleware layer and the user information stored in a JWT token. The middleware layer fetched the user roles from the managed CCF application. As you could see from the screen, the only action available to a farmer is harvest. We will proceed to create an entry to advertise the harvesting of the beans. The next few screens will show the different personas logging into the application and performing their respective actions. As we move along, the change in the state field shows the progress of the coffee beans as it moves through different stages in the pipeline. The managed CCF application used in this demo is published in GitHub and can be used as a boilerplate to speed up the migration of other applications. So to summarize, a managed CCF application is a good fit if you're trying to share sensitive information with other organizations in a secure cloud environment, and also have granular control over the data. The Azure platform provides high availability and guarantees performance to meet your business needs. developers can use existing tools and libraries and use the sample application code published in GitHub to quickly lift and shift their applications and integrate it with a managed CCF application. For more information, please follow the links on the screen. Thank you for your time.